Hello friend, welcome back. In this video, I will discuss about the route with live example. For finding out the routes, you have to go to your main directory and then you have to go this routes folder, and into the route folder there is a web.php. So now just open it. In the route, they have the two parameter. One is the URL and one is the callback. And you can see that is actually the function and return view. So that is actually the callback parameter and that is the URL parameter. Now here this URL actually indicated our home. Like if you go to our page, like there is a pro and then news, then automatically there is a default one of the page that is the welcome page. So now this URL actually indicating as a home, and here there is our view welcome. Okay, like if you go to the resources and here there is a view file, and here you can see there is another file as a welcome. So here this URL, in that means that our home URL is indicating to view this page, that means the welcome page, and into the view option area that is one of the page by default is a welcome. So for the reasons our welcome page, that means welcome blade.php, this file is loaded on particular disposition. So I will also cover the view, how can create the view page, how can create the controller, and with the controller how can control your view, all that file I will discuss about that things later. Right now I just want to work in our routes. So first of all, here I just want to do, like here I just want to create another route. Like here I just copied and pasted on here, and here to this position I just name it as a hello. Okay, so here I just added one of the URL as a hello, and now I just want to return it. Like here I just put returned as a hello world. So here I just return as a hello world, and now if you save it, like I just click on the save all, and if you now access this URL, that means this hello URL, like check this out, I just put the hello and now click on the enter. Now you see it's now display as a hello world, that means this message. Okay, so now I just create another one. Like here I just create another one as a football. And into this position, I just want to return some of the things on particular dispositions, like as a, I just put as a, oh, I love football. So here I just defining as a I love football. And now if you click on the save all, and if you now access this URL, so here I just define that this URL as a football. And if you now click on the enter, now you can see it's now showing as a I love football. So I hope you can well understand about it. Now let's create one of the dynamic route. As I told you, in the route they have the six type of route method. Like there is a get method, there is a put method, there is a fetch method, and there is the delete method. Okay, so right now I am actually working with the get method. So laterally I will also show you all that method, then it will be very much clear to you. So for now I just want to create one of the dynamic route, then it will be better. Okay, so for now I just copy it, and here I just paste that things on particular disposition. Like here I just want to do like one of the user. Okay, I just define the URL as a user, and one of the user pass some of the ID. So here I just define one of the parameter on particular disposition, and here I have to do, I have to assign the second bracket, and into this position I just define one of the ID. So this user will be actually pass some of the ID. So first of all, you have to do, you have to actually get this ID into this function area. So here I just get that ID with the dollar sign and then the ID, and into this position I just want to return it. Okay, so here I just want to return it with that, like here I just define the your ID is, and then I just want to do, I just want to actually concrete with the dot, and then here I just define this ID. Okay, so here I just define this ID on particular disposition. And now if you click on the save all, like I just click on the save all, and now if you access this, like there is the user and there is the ID. So here I just copy it, and into this position I just define that user, and here I pass some of the ID. Okay, like I just pass the 4 ID, and if you click on the enter, now here you can see it's now showing as a your ID is 4. So now it's actually total dynamic. So if you put as a 444, and if you click on the enter, then you can see it's now showing as a value your ID is 444. But here one thing, like here for now I am actually using that some of the numeric data. Okay, so if you click on the enter, now you can see it's now showing as a numeric data. But here, if you want to access some of the text, okay, like if you want to access some of the demo text and click on the enter, now you can see it's also showing the name. Okay, so here I just want to prevent it, so we can remove it with using the regular expression. So how can do that work? Like here I just only want to allow that numeric data. Okay, so they have no digit will be allowed on particular disposition. For doing this, here I just want to add some of that regular expression. So here I added our regular expression. So if you want to add the regular expressions, like here I just define the where, okay, and into the where position here, first of all I just define our ID. So this ID only I allowed some of the values, and here I just define our expressions. Like here I just define our expression, I just only allow the 0 to 9. So here I just define the 0 to 9, and I also want to make the things as a repeated, so for the reasons I just added the plus. Okay, so if you now like click on the save all, like I just click on the save all, and if you now refresh that page, now you can see now here I just added some of the text. For the reasons he didn't find out any data. Okay, that means here you can see this showing as a page not found. But here if you add some of the numeric data and if you click on the enter, now here you can see it's now showing as a your ID is 565. So that is actually the regular expression. You can also allocate that things with particular disposition. And here one things you have to remember, like when you create one of the method into the main method, okay, that means this call actually the method chaining. For right now here I just define that where, that means this regular expression as a method chaining. Okay, so for now here I just using that things on particular disposition. Hope you can well understand about it. And now I just also want to show you how you can add the optional parameter into the route. How can do that work? For doing this, like here I just want to pass the ID and another optional parameter on particular dispositions. Like here I just defining another optional parameter, like I just name it as a name. And when you want to make the things optional, then here you have to assign the questions mark. Okay, so for now here first of all here I just define one of the ID. So right now I just take another parameter, so for the reasons I just define the another parameter on here ID. So now here I just defining the name, so I just defining the name, and default I just put some of the name on here as Ariyan. Okay, so right now I just put the name as Ariyan, and now I also want to visible it. So if you want to visible it, like here I just defining as again like here I just defining the name as a and your name is, and then here I just concrete this one, and then our this variable, that means this name variable. So here I just assign our name variable on particular disposition. So now let's check this out. Here I just click on the save all, and now if you go to this position, and now here that is our user, that is the ID, and I also added one of the optional. But now here I just defining as a Kazi, and if you click on the enter, now you can see it's now showing as a your ID is 565, and here is your name is a Kazi. So that means that is actually our optional, and by default I just set up as a Kazi, but if you make the things as a black, now you can see it's now showing as a default value as a Ariyan. So here I just define the default value as a Ariyan. So when it should be the null, then this Ariyan will be visible rather than it should be visible the name. Okay, so here I just defining that name, like here I just better I just put some of these spaces on here. Okay, then it's a little better, I just put some of these spaces, and now I just do again like there is user and then our ID. So here I just define the ID as a 77, and also I just make that things as a null. Now here you can see it's now showing as a your ID is 77 and default name as Ariyan. But if you want to add that optional parameter like as a Khan, okay, I just defined the Khan, and now it's now showing as your name is Khan. So I hope you can well understand about it. So that's all about the routes. For now here I only use the get method. So now that's all about our route, and here that is our URL and that is our callback. Okay, so that is actually the two parameter is using in the route area. So in our next video I will discuss about the controller, how can create controller, how can actually control your view with the controller. Step by step I will show you each and everything with live example. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.